That was Katie Mitchell and Carlos Pubon, contestants of the Memory Ball Dancing Stars fundraising event. It benefits the Alzheimer's Association, and here to tell us more about it is Ellen Torres, the association's development director. Welcome.
I am pleased to be here. Thank you for having me.
I'm happy to have you here. Your dancers were wonderful.
They are wonderful. They work very hard.
They do work very hard. So tell me more about this ball.
So this is our annual gala.
Yes.
And it's different than other galas in Baltimore. We don't have auctions. We don't have all the big, long programs. We have individuals or couples who decide that they're going to dance in the middle of the dancing floor in front of 700-800 people and raise money through their dancing.
And who are these people? Just people in the community?
People in the community, community leaders, people who have a connection to the disease or in some way or another feel like it's this is the time for them to get involved and to do something. And they literally put their feet and their hearts together in this effort.
Now, they are collaborating with a professional dancer.
Yes, absolutely.
And then the people who are dancing can be novices.
Many of them are, and there are some that are dancing with a professional that evening, and some are coached by. So Carlos, for instance, who's dancing with Kadeen, has in the past also coached some couples.
Okay.
So, yes.
So Kadeen is not a professional dancer, though.
No.
She just looks like one because of Carlos.
That's right, absolutely.
There you go. All right, so the people who are participating, and you told me why they want to participate, but who is actually benefiting from their participation?
Well, the Alzheimer's Association, this is one of our biggest fundraisers, and it is benefiting the 110,000 people here in Maryland and their families who are touched by the disease.
So why is this so important in terms of raising money? I know, and how is the money being allocated, I guess, if that makes sense?
Yeah. Well, it is not only raising money, but it's raising awareness. Alzheimer's disease is still a disease that many people don't talk about. There is a certain stigma that's involved with it, and we're trying to have people realize that this is a brain disease, and just as people have gotten comfortable talking about other medical conditions like diabetes or heart disease or cancer, this is a medical disease. This is not just, a normal part of aging, you start to lose your memory.
Right.
And so it funds the services of the association, which are free to families. We offer caregiver services. We offer support groups, a 24/7 helpline, that there is somebody always on the other end of the phone, no matter what time of day or night you call, with answers, with advice, sometimes just a listening ear. And it's one of the many things that we do.
Yes, I mean, what a support and what a resource, especially for family members and caregivers that are trying to navigate this, because really the disease touches so many people.
It really does, and it's growing more and more every single day. As the baby boomers are aging, there are more chances. Your most common reasons for getting Alzheimer's are brain, if you have a brain, and age.
Right.
And so the alternative to not aging is to not live long enough. So people are living, and they are living with the disease more and more.
Well, this is such a fun event, a way that it really has an impact for our community. And so our dancers are, they'll actually be able to vote on the favorite dancers.
Yes, $1,
so how do you
one
do
vote.
That? Yes. $1, one vote.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so do they do that in real time, online? How do they go about supporting?
So right now, you can go onto the Memory Ball website, and you can actually vote right now. So you can vote for Kadeen, you can look at the dancers, you can read their stories, why they're doing this, and you can actually cast a vote by buying a ticket or just making a straight contribution. Then that evening, it's in real time.
Okay.
And they win. There's two different trophies. One of them, the one that is the big trophy of the night, is the UR Star. That is the trophy for the top fundraiser. But there's also the judge's choice for the best dance.
Oh, wow.
And then there's runner-ups.
So I want the viewers to know, because I want them to see this. The Memory Ball Dancing Stars, A Night at the Copacabana, takes place Saturday, April 27th at the Baltimore Marriott Waterfront. So for tickets or to cast your vote, like Ellen just told us, you can cast your vote for your favorite dancer. Just visit that website that's on the screen right there or search BaltimoreMemoryBall.com. All right, just not even the .com, just search that.
That's right.
You're all set.
It's a scary thing to do, so we love to have support behind the
dancers.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much,
Ellen.
Really appreciate it. We'll be right back with more Midday Maryland right after this. Stay tuned.